Of the United States, the peoples of a number of countries of the world have recently had totalitarian regimes forced upon them against their will. The government of the United States has made frequent protests against coercion and intimidation in violation of the Yalta Agreement in Poland, Rumania, and Bulgaria. I must also state that in a number of other countries, there have been similar developments. At the present moment, in world history, nearly every nation must choose between alternative ways of life. The choice is too often not a free one. One way of life is based upon the will of the majority and is distinguished by free institutions, representative government, free elections, guarantees of individual liberty, freedom of speech and religion, and freedom from political oppression. The second way of life is based upon the will of a minority, forcibly imposed upon the majority. It relies upon terror and oppression, a controlled press and radio, fixed elections, and the suppression of personal freedom. I believe that it must be the policy of the United States to support free peoples who are resisting attempted subjugation by armed minorities or by outside pressures. I believe that we must assist free peoples to work out their own destinies in their own way. The free peoples of the world look to us for support in maintaining their freedom. If we falter in our leadership, we may have been placed upon us by the swift movement of events. I am confident that the Congress will face these responsibilities squarely.